This feels good. Come up to the fire, ladies.
I'm not cold.
Now, Mr. Hill, you explained to Mr. Henson just what you saw when you came here yesterday morning.
By the way, has anything been moved? Are things just as you left them yesterday?
Well, yeah. It's just the same. When Jocko was here last night, I felt we had to send Frank out. To start a fire course? I know you skipped the morning with a big case on. I told him not to touch anything except the stove. And well, you know Frank.
Somebody should have been left here with him yesterday.
Oh, yesterday? When I had to send Frank out for the man that went crazy at Moore Center, I want you to know I had my hands full yesterday, and I know you can get back from Omaha by today. And as long as I land over everything here myself,
now, Mr. Hill, tell just what happened when you got here yesterday morning.
Harry and I started the town with a little tennis. We came along the road from my house, and as we got here, I said, I'm going to see if John Wright wants to join me on a party telephone. We had spoken about it once before, but he put me on, saying folks talk too much anyway, and all he wanted was peace and quiet. I guess you know about how much he talked himself, but I thought maybe if we went to the house and talked about it before his wife, though I said to Harry I wasn't sure about what his wife wanted made much difference to John.
I'd like to talk more about that a little later. I do want to talk about that. But tell now, just what happened when you got into the house?
I didn't hear or see anything. I knocked on the door, and it was still all quiet inside. I knew they must be up. It was past 8 o'clock. So I knocked again, and I thought I heard someone say, come in. I wasn't sure, I'm not sure yet, but I opened the door, that door. And there in that rocker sat Miss Wright.
What was she doing?
Well, she was rocking, back and forth. She had her apron in her hand, and she was kind of pleating.
And how did she look?
Well, she looked queer.
How do you mean, queer?
Well, as if she didn't know what she was going to do next, and kind of dumbass.
And how did she seem to feel about their coming?
Well, I don't think she minded one way or another. She didn't pay much attention. I said, how do, Miss Wright? It's cold, ain't it? She said, is it? And went on pleating at her apron. Well, I was surprised. She didn't ask me to come up to the stove or to sit down, but just sat there, not even looking at me. So I said, I want to see John. And then she laughed. I guess you could call it a laugh. I thought of Harry and the team outside, so I said a little sharp, can't I see John? No, says she, kind of stove-like. Ain't he home, says I. Yes, says she, he's home. Then why can't I see him? I asked her, out of patience. Because he's dead, says she. Dead? Says I. She just nodded her head, not being a bit excited, but rocking, back and forth. Well, where is he? I asked her, not knowing what to say. She is playing upstairs, like that. I got up with the idea of going up there, all from here to there, and I says, well, what did he die of? He died of a rope around his neck, said she. Well, I went out and called Harry. I thought I might need help. He went upstairs and there he was lying.
I think I'd rather have you go into that upstairs, where you can point everything out. Just go on now with the rest of the story.
Well, my first thought was to get that rope off. It looked. But Harry, he went up to him and he said, no, he's dead all right, and we better not touch anything. So we went right back downstairs. She was still sitting in that same way. Has anybody been notified? I asked. No, said she. I'm concerned. Who did this, Miss Wright? Said Harry. He sounded businesslike, and she stopped the pleating of her apron. I don't know, said she. You don't know? Says Harry. No, says she. Were you sleeping in the bed? Yes, says she. But I was on the inside. Somebody slipped the rope around his neck and strangled him, and you didn't wake up, says Harry. I didn't wake up, she said after him. He must have looked as if we didn't see how that could be, for after a minute, she said, I slipped him. Harry was going to ask her more questions, but I said, maybe we ought to let her tell her story first to the coroner or the sheriff. So Harry went as fast as he could to Rivers Place where there's a telephone.
And what did Miss Wright do when where she knew you had gone, to the coroner?
Well, she went from this chair to that one over there, and just sat there, with her hands held together and looking down. I had got the feeling that I should make some conversation, so I said I had come to see if John wanted to put in the telephone lines, and then she laughed, and then she looked at me, scared. I don't know. Maybe it wasn't scared. I wouldn't like to say it was. Soon Harry got back, and then Dr. Lloyd came, and you, Mr. Peters. So I guess that's all I know that you know.
I guess we'll go upstairs first, and then out to the barn and around there. Now you're positive that there's nothing else here that would point to any kind of motive?
Nothing here but fishy things.
Here's a nice mess.
Oh, her fur did freeze. She worried about that when it got cold out. She said the fire go out and her drawers would break.
Well, can you beat the women, hell for murder, and worrying about her preserves?
I think when we're third here, she may have something more serious than preserves to worry about.
Well, women are used to worrying over trifles.
To be sure. And yet, what would we do without the ladies? Dirty towels. How much of a housekeeper would you say, ladies?
There's a great deal of work to be done on a farm.
To be sure. And yet, there are some Dixon County farmhouses which don't have such roller towels.
Well, those towels get dirty awful quick. Men's hands aren't always as clean as one might think.
Ah, lawyer to your sex, I see. But you and Miss Wright were neighbors. I suppose you were friends, too?
I've not seen much of her in late years. I've not been in this house for years.
And why was that? You didn't like her?
I liked her well and all. It just never seemed a real cheerful place.
No, it's not cheerful. I shouldn't say she had the homemaking instinct.
Well, I wouldn't say if John Wright had either.
You mean they didn't get on very well?
I didn't mean anything. It's just the home wouldn't be any more cheerful with John Wright in it.
I'd like to talk more about that later. I'm gonna get the lay of things upstairs first.
I suppose anything is big. Dells will be all right. For her to take in some clothes and a few little things. We left in such a hurry yesterday.
Yes, but I'd like to see what you take, Miss Peters. And keep an eye out for anything that might be of use to us.
Yes, Mr. Anderson.
I'd hate to have a man come into my home, snooping around and criticizing.
Of course, it's no more than their duty.
Duty's all right, but I bet that deputy sheriff that came out and stopped that fire got a little of that on. I should have thought of that sooner.
She had bread set. Looks like she was going to put it in the box. I wonder if all her food's gone.
Well, I declare I believe this is the only one. She'll feel awful bad of all her hard work and that terrible heat. I remember when I put my cherries up last summer.
Well, I must go get those things from the front room. You come in with me, too? You can help me carry them. In this house. That's what they don't understand. And Mr. Henderson,
our time with the little things while they're looking for evidence?
Box. What happened to her?
Amen.
My kid. A boy took a hatchet and went out.
except for her reason for doing it. But you know juries when it comes to women. And there's some definite thing, something to show, something to make a story about, something connected with a strange way of doing it.
Well, got the men around. It's pretty cool out there.
I think I want to stay here for a while by myself. You can send Frank out for me, can't you? I'm not satisfied that we hang you there.
You want to see what this meter's going to take in?
Not very dangerous being the way to pick that out. Besides, the sheriff's wife's practically married to the law. Ever think of it that way, Miss Peters?
Not just that way.
Married to the law. Come in here for a minute, George. We've got to take a look at these windows.
Ah, windows.
We'll be right back, Mr. Hale.
It is kind of you're not going to quilt it. He was going to...